In this video, I will demonstrate how to set up push notification alerts from iDVR surveillance DVRs to the MobileCMS app for iPhone. Please note that this app is also available for iPad and Android mobile devices, and the setup is the same. On the left side of the screen, I'm displaying a live view that I captured from the DVR. Let's get started. So to configure the app for push alerts, I'm going to go ahead and open it up. And then once I'm in here, you'll see I just have the one DVR, the demo DVR in a warehouse that is already configured. There's that link there that says edit APNS. You click on that link, it opens up the push list. And this particular DVR is set up to send push notifications to three different devices. The top entry is to this phone, which is the iPhone 5 that we're on. So I'm going to tap to open up the configuration area for this phone. And then if I click on motion, it will open up and basically asking me which channels do I want enabled to get alerts from. And the only channel that I have enabled is channel 4. So I'm going to click done. And then I already have this set up, but if I wanted to set up the time frame for which the push alerts are active, you could do that in here, your start and end time. Basically, I have this enabled for 24 hours. And then when you're done with these settings, click done there and done again. And what that just did is that saved that configuration to the DVR. And now we're set up to receive push messages based on motion activated from camera 4. Okay, so here we are looking at the main interface of the iDVR-E, and if I click on the menu button on the remote and log into the interface, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the camera settings and show you the motion area that I've set up for camera 4. So if I go down here to motion grid, you see in the upper right that shaded light blue area. That's the area that's defined to trigger motion. The rest of the grid that's clear will not trigger any motion. You can see as I'm moving around, it shows you how the DVR is detecting motion in that entire grid. So then if I exit out of there and I go into record, I will show you how in the record setup, I have if we look at camera 4 down here, it's configured on motion to record based on motion from itself, from camera 4. So camera 4 records on motion from camera 4. That's what this entry here is saying. So now I'll go back out to the main menu, and I will go walk over to trigger the motion. And you'll see on the DVR that the motion icon appears, and the channel number lights up in red, indicating that recording was triggered. And I get a push notification on my iPhone that looks like this. I'll tap on the launch button so I can go into the MobileCMS app, and I'll load the DVR that just sent us the alert. Here's a four-camera live view of the DVR right now. And if I tap on camera 4, it'll go to a single camera view of camera 4. And this really enables the user to log in immediately and see a live view of what's going on. Users can even go back and play the recorded video, although I'm not going to cover that in this video. We do have other videos showing how to go back and play back recorded video from the mobile app. And that's it. It's as simple as that. I hope you found this video useful in explaining how easy it is to use the iDVR to receive push notifications based on motion events. If you have any questions, please contact us at this URL. Thank you for watching.